What's up, guys? What's going on? Today I'm going to be going through the 2015 Giants schedule, 2015 to 2016 season Giants schedule. It's a pretty good schedule for us. I'm pretty happy with it. There's nothing too much that I don't like. We'll start off with the Dallas Cowboys. We'll be facing them at Dallas. Sunday Night Football, and I'm not complaining about it. I'm okay with it for the most part, but I kind of like rivalry games at towards the end half of the season. I don't really like them like earlier in the season. I know it's good to start off with, you know, but I mean early in the season, everyone's weak. Nobody's really playing to their full potential. Until you're about to get out the playoffs, like late in the season when people are really trying to get into the playoffs and they play their hardest and people are still learning their new plays and all that. Sunday Night Football, not bad, but week one is against Dallas. I can't wait for this game. By the way, the New York Giants have 5 primetime games and they have 3 4 o'clock games, so I'll be able to see 8 games for the Giants. Thank God, because I live in the Tampa area. If you guys don't know, I'll be able to see 8 games. I'm actually going to the Tampa game, so look on TV to see if you see me. So next we have the we're going against at the Atlanta Falcons at our home. Little repeat of last year. Last year we faced them week 3, I believe. Oh, week 4? Week 4, yeah. So, this is a 1 o'clock game. Unfortunately, I probably won't be able to watch this one. Can you stop? I probably won't be able to watch this one, so... I'm not going to say who's going to win and who's going to lose, being that we're in late April. So, the draft didn't even happen yet. And, you know, you don't know who's injured, you don't know in practice, you know, I don't think anybody's doing the win and loss kind of thing. But I'll give an estimation, I'll give a non-definite estimation when I finish this up. So, Washington week 3, Thursday night football, so we have a Sunday night football game, then 1 o'clock, then a Thursday night football game, so pretty happy with that. I hope it doesn't work out the Giants too much. We're facing the Washington Redskins at our house. Last time we faced them at our house, we beat them 26 to 13. I'm not sure actually. 26 to 13. That's what I'm going with. Or 28 to 13. 28 to 13. I don't know. But wow, I'm reading this mock draft right now that Todd McShay and Mel Kiper is doing, and they have the New York Giants selecting Todd Gurley, running back out of Georgia. Those guys are stupid. I don't know, man. Sometimes I think that I could take their job, honestly. I think anybody could take their job. Anyway. Oh, yeah, so Washington, we face them Thursday Night Football. Next, week 4, we are at Buffalo. This will be a 1 o'clock game. I circled this. This game, I really like this game. Buffalo is a underestimated team who can beat opponents that they shouldn't beat, like the Green Bay Packers, and they'll lose to opponents that they shouldn't lose to, like the Oakland Raiders. I'm referencing on to last year. This is a team that's on and off. Solid running backs like C.J. Spiller and Fred Jackson. Unfortunately, C.J. Spiller isn't there yet, but you upgraded. Huge big time with LeSean McCoy, and you bring in defensive-minded coach Rex Ryan, who has a lot of toys to play with on that defense, especially that defensive line is very scary. Unfortunately, he can't work with Kiko Alonso because now he's on the Eagles, and we have to deal with him twice a year, but I'd rather deal with Kiko twice a year than LeSean McCoy because that guy runs all over us, like over 120 yards every game, so, you know, that's that. So, yeah, we face Buffalo in a 1 o'clock game. Pretty good. I like that. Week 5, we face the San Francisco 49ers at our house again. Sunday Night Football. Now, last time, we should have won that that game. I don't care. We should have won that game. Larry Donnell should have caught that touchdown. If Eli Manning didn't throw five interceptions like Eli Manning does, we probably would have won that game pretty well because Colin Kaepernick was really having a hard time scoring. If you watch that game, the game wound up being 16-10. And the Giants got in the end zone, in the red zone so many times, but Eli just kept getting picked off and picked off. If he didn't get picked off, we'd probably be like, it would be probably like 30-16 or something like that. But anyway, undrafted in first round. Oh, wow, okay. Anyway, no, I was reading something from NFL Live. So yeah, Sunday Night Football. And then right after that Sunday Night Football game against the San Francisco 49ers, we play Philadelphia at a Monday Night Football game. This is exactly how I think we were at Philadelphia when we got beat 27-0. So, I mean, I hope we win this game, man. Like, honestly, the only team that I really fear in our rivalry is the Philadelphia Eagles. You may say Dallas Cowboys, but Dallas Cowboys have the tendency to choke. The Eagles have the tendency to dominate us the seasons. This goes far back as, you know, God knows when. Like, honestly, like we get our fair share of hits in. Like we remember when we beat the Philadelphia Eagles like 42-7. But they have always had the upper hand of the New York Giants, and they sweeped us. I think they had three wins. I think the last time we won against them was late 2 years ago, when they were at our house, I believe. So, I mean, I'm Monday Night Football, I just hope they're not pumped, you know. I just hope, you know, the players aren't on their game, you know, slacking off. So, that's that. The seventh week, we face Dallas again, so not even going into week 10, we'll have already faced the Dallas Cowboys twice. So that means we don't have to deal with Greg Hardy because he has a 10-game suspension. So am I okay with that? Of course. I don't want to deal with Greg Hardy. That guy's a monster. He's going to want to be coming back. He's going to want to be making a comeback to prove himself because he only has 6 games to prove himself before he is a free agent again and has to be signed to another team or possibly get re-signed to the Dallas Cowboys. So he's going to be playing with passion. And I don't want to be in his way. So, the Giants won't play him. They won't be able to see him in the Dallas uniform. So, yeah, we face the Dallas at a 4:25 game at our house. So, that's that. Then we faced New Orleans at New Orleans. Last time this happened, we dominated New Orleans like 57-27 or 57-28 or 57-35? It's one of that. I mean, we killed them. David Wilson, his rookie year, had 327 all-purpose yards. So rushing yards, receiving yards, kickoff, punt return. He had all 327 all-purpose yards, set a Giants record for all-purpose yards. So, I mean, will that happen again? These are not the same teams we saw before. Giants gotten worse, and in my opinion, New Orleans Saints gotten better. You could say they went 7-9. I mean, every team has their struggles, honestly. But you could say they got a little better. Maybe their defense got a little softer. Well, actually, their offense got a lot softer, too, being a Jimmy Graham ain't there no more. But I just don't feel like we're going to score 57 points, if you catch my drift. So next, we are going to week 9. We're going to be at Tampa Bay. Thankfully, I live in the Tampa Bay area, so I'm going to be going to this game. Perfect timing, too. I wanted a 4 o'clock game. This will be taking place at 4:05. I can't wait to see this game. Not because it's like a good matchup or anything, because I think the Giants were going to win this one. But I've never been to a Giants game before, so this will be my first one. And I hope the Giants win, because I was supposed to go to that Jacksonville game. I wound up not going. Thank goodness, because I would have been so mad had the Giants lose, and I was surrounded by Jacksonville fans. You know, I'm a trash talker, man. So if someone come up to me talking trash, I'll talk trash back. But I can't back it up with us losing to Jacksonville. That's that. And week 10, Super Bowl 42 and Super Bowl 46 matchup. The New England Patriots, I've been wanting to face them so much because I'm tired of people saying that we lose to them in the regular season. We will never win to them in the regular season. It's not even important. Well, this is a 425 game, so this is going to be Troy Aikman and Joe Buck commentating this game. So this is the game of the week because the game of the week are at 425. So, obviously Troy Aikman and Joey Buck love this game. So, this is not going to be a game that the Giants will definitely lose. I believe the Giants have a chance. I sound like some kind of fanboy right now. But honestly, I need the Giants to win. We beat you in 2 Super Bowls, New England. It wasn't a fluke because it happened twice. It's not a fluke. Who cares about regular season games, but I just want to, you know, shut all those people up. The Giants, hopefully, will win this game. Hopefully, we'll be on some kind of, you know, on a right track. Eli has, like, 75 completion rating, completion percentage, and Rashad Jennings is, like, past, you know, probably past 1,000 yards right now, you know. But anyway, right after the New England game, we'll probably get beat up and probably get our butt whooped, so we deserve a bye week after that and get settled for to go to Washington for a 1 o'clock game, which we'll be fine at. Then the Snoopy Bowl, the MetLife Bowl, the New York Bowl, the I don't know, some people may call it the Toilet Bowl because they all we both suck. I'm not gonna lie. It's a 1 o'clock game. The New York Jets will be wearing our uniforms, because honestly, I'm a diehard New York Giants fan, but I think our away uniforms are ugly. Anyway, our home uniforms are beautiful, but our away uniforms, they look like practice uniforms, honestly. I mean, that's just a Giants tradition. I know that that's been the away uniform for a long time, but that's just not my thing. I mean, you know, it's just, I think they should upgrade, honestly. They should put more blue on it, you know? You're the Giants, you're the New York Giants, you put more blue on it. I'm getting off track. Anyway, we'll be facing the New York Jets. Last time we demolished them. Victor Cruz had a 99-yard reception against them last time we faced in 2012. It was a hardly contested game, but we wound up pulling out the win late in the game. Eli came for a comeback. We weren't really trailing in that game, is that we were, like, tightly contested, and then we slowly, due to interceptions and fumbles, we slowly got back up there. And this is a totally different team from 2012, mind you. Okay? I mean, Darrell Revis and Antonio Cromartie are coming back, and they were there in 2012 on that game. But, mind you, Antonio Cromartie is like a million years old now, and Darrell Revis is getting older as well. So, you can only see what they have. And the Giants have like barely anyone on their roster that played in 2012, because we totally cleaned our roster out. So, the new faces everywhere. I mean, Mathias Kiwanuka isn't even here anymore. So, you know, yeah. So, the Jets, we face the Jets week 13. Week 14, we're at Miami, Monday Night Football. That's our last primetime game. And then, I hope Ndamukong Suh, leave me alone, man. Leave Eli alone. Leave Eli alone, man. I'm telling you. I hope, I mean, Ndamukong Suh is really, it's, I mean, didn't the Dolphins finish like third in defense last year? You're adding Ndamukong Suh? Are you kidding me? Honestly. Anyway, enough with that. Then we, 15, 16, and 17 will be all 1 o'clock games. We'll be facing Carolina at our house. We'll be going to Minnesota. And then to finish off the season, we'll be facing Philadelphia at our house. All in all, it's a good schedule. I hope you kept up. I like to get off track. I'm Hispanic. I tend to get off track and I tend to use my hands. And so, anyway, I think this is a good schedule, probably better than last year's. So let me go through right now and tell you guys what I think what happened with the New York Giants. Okay, Dallas, you never know. So I'll realistically, I'll probably give it a loss. So we start off with 0-1, 1-1, 2-1, It's 3-1, 4-1, 4-2, 4-3. Probably lose to Dallas again. 4-4, 5-4, 5-5, 6-5, 7-5. I believe we could pull off the win against Miami. 8-5, Carolina. Yeah, Carolina, yeah. 9-5. Minnesota will beat them. 10-5. And then Philadelphia, will probably lose against Philadelphia both years again. So, 10-6 is what I'm going after. This is non-definite. The draft hasn't started yet. You know, you don't know who's playing what yet. You don't know who's injured, who's coming back yet. So, I mean, if you're a New York Giants fan or not, don't go by what I say here. I will make my predictions after the draft, and I will make my final predictions. They will be right before preseason. I made them a little early last year. This was like, you know, months before preseason, but I'm going to make them right before preseason, okay? So, that's it. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this wasn't too long. I hope you guys were entertained. Please leave a like, guys. It helps me out a lot. I really want to grow this channel out. I won't be just doing football talk. I know some people get bored of football talk all the time. If you like video games, I'm hoping to save up for a capture card. I have a lot of stuff in store. My cousin actually has a channel that he posts GTA and Call of Duty on, all that stuff. So if you like that stuff, I'll leave the link down below. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys in the next New York Giants related video or something like that. Bye.